blessed. I just want to thank God for this opportunity. Pastor Kelly called my husband and asked him to do the quilting program. So I'm just praying for Danny, praying for Danny. I think a couple weeks later he called and he said, "Can your wife speak also?" I said, "Well, then who's going to pray for you if I have to speak?" I said, "Are you sure Pastor Kelly wants?" He said, "My name? He said me?" So I just thank God for being here this morning, and truly I just honor the God that sent you, Pastor Kelly. My fruit is gentleness, and I was in the house, and I was in the refrigerator, and I was going to make some banana nut bread. All right. And all this week, while I just kept studying, I found some bananas. Some actually rotten sweet bananas, and this is what we make when we make our banana nut bread. Right. But I can't make it because my kids have seen the skin color of it. We go to the grocery store, the first thing that I do, I go to the fruit, and I pick out the creased fruit, the roundest fruit, the fruit that doesn't have any bruises or any tarnishes on them. And even if I send my daughter to go give, she bring back the bananas, I'd be like, that got brown stuff on already. That's going to be like that in 2 days. Go back and give me some more. So I'm the fifth fruit, which represents grace and the gift of God.
Yeah.
And number five, that's what it means, that the grace and gift of God. And we definitely need his grace and his gift to have gentleness.
Amen.
The fruit of the Spirit comes directly from the Holy Spirit. That's why Spirit is capitalized in your Bible. When you see it, and it's not in the beginning, if it's in the middle, it has a capital S. And it represents God's, it's a deeper sanctification process with God.
Amen.
In Galatians 5:22, the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and temperance. Against such, there is no law.
Right.
And by bearing God's fruit, we walk in the Spirit and not in the flesh.
Yes.
The definition of gentleness means kindly, amiable, a gentle manner,
right,
not severe, not rough,
yeah,
or violent, mild, patient, and even tempered. Ungentle means harsh, threatening in manner,
yeah,
or in appearance, demanding, hot-blooded, and severe. The Greek word is praetus, which means meekness, which is a misconception of being weak or cowardliness. And I know sometimes, man, when you think about the fruit of the Spirit, gentle, you think maybe it's kind of like a woman thing, like, you know, that's for ladies. But I was reminded in the Bible, I started studying Elijah. And Elijah was great in battle. He won many of them. He was a great man. And as he went to win the battle of apostasy, he asked God to rain down Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. We say Jacob. He said in Israel, and bring the fire down and burn up this place and show these people that I'm with you and that I am God and I am mighty.
Right.
So God did that. But if you keep reading, the very next day,
right,
he was running from Jezebel.
Right.
Ahab's wife.
Right.
And he was found in a cave. And he didn't come out. But God sent these great theological things, just like he sent with the people. When he burnt that offering, he sent up the flames and all the fires came down. He said, "Elijah, where are you?" He's hiding in the cave.
Right.
So God sent an earthquake. Nothing happened. He sent a great and mighty wind.
Come on.
Elijah still didn't hear him.
All right.
After that, he sent fire. The same fire he called down. Nothing happened.
Come on.
But when God called him with a still, small, gentle voice, something awakened in him. And he came out and he stood in the middle of the cave. And he told God, "I am jealous of your people." He started beginning to tell the story. But and that and the gentle spirits what drove him out. James and John got so upset that he said, they said, "Well, call down as he is gentle. Gentleness doesn't come naturally to all or easy.
Right.
It's something that we all must learn.
Yeah.
A gentle word or a gentle touch is everything. Gentleness is the ability to receive from Jesus and his healing, saving power and the deliverance power in our lives. And wives, we know when we're more gentle, we get more things from our husbands, right?
All right.
When I go to my husband, I say, "Who's gonna remember me? You gonna remember me back too? You know what you want?" But I get what I want to say. You know, like how do you approach, touch, the look? How do you do conversations, everything? So can you imagine if we go to Jesus and ask him for things in a nice and gentle way? What more could we get? What is being held up because you're not being gentle? Not only that, when you want something from your boss, you don't go in there and say, "Hey, I want to be emotional." But why we don't do that? Because we might want to say something harsh to our husbands at times because they give us the paychecks. So there's different ways how we communicate to different people. When we aren't gentle, we are neglecting God's word. And the benefits and the rewards of gentleness. It turns away wrath. It's rest for our souls.
Yeah.
A wise and gentle man winneth souls. Mm-hmm. It's a prerequisite to enter God's presence. Today our world regards hostility, rewards hostility. Look at all the television programs and all the video games that's coming out now. And the last thing I want to say, I'll leave you with a Christian quote. It's from Max Lucado. He says, "I choose gentleness. Gentleness. Nothing is won by force. I choose to be gentle. If I raise my fist, may it be in prayer. If I make a demand, may it be only to myself." In 2 Timothy 2:24, "The servant of the Lord must not strive but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach, patient in meekness, instructing those that oppose themselves." So when you oppose yourself, when you're not gentle, you're not using any of the fruits of the Spirit, you're opposing yourself.
Yeah.
So let's walk into the Spirit so we don't reap the corruption of our flesh, that we don't do fleshly things.
Yeah. Right.
And so that God can reward us, not just in openly, but in secret.
Amen. Amen.